Have you been looking for a somewhat compact, foldable 220-watt solar panel? Then the EcoFlow 220-watt bifold solar panel might be what you're looking for. I have both the 110-watt variant as well as the 60-watt variant, which I compare this particular solar panel to, as well as using it with several EcoFlow power banks and a few others from other manufacturers. With that in mind, I'm Wanderer 001. Let's get into it. One of the things that I always appreciate about EcoFlow's solar panels is the carrying case that you get with them. Here you can see you got a little EcoFlow branding there, but you have a nice textured, padded, somewhat protective case for your panels, as well as up here, you have this fake leather hand grip up here, which wraps around both the handles and is kind of padded, giving you some cushioning for trying to carry this panel. In its closed state, the carrying case with panels inside measures 33 inches by 20 inches and comes in at 20.9 pounds. Case itself actually acts as a kickstand for the solar panel when it's in its open state. But unlike other EcoFlow cases that I've tested, when we flip this one over, we could see there's actually a little accent piece down there, a little extra rubberized protection down there, as well as if we flip it up, you can see there's extra reinforcement on this end to help with the very large, heavy panels. One of the things I also like about EcoFlow's cases is you can see right here, it's a weaved zipper. It acts as a way of waterproofing it. So here you can see the actual zipper and then the top layer for the waterproof closure. Opening the case up itself, you can see some of the hanging points for the solar panel. And while the top layer is padded a little more than you get with a standard EcoFlow carrying case, they still do not have the hard plastic piece on the front and the back. So there is a hard plastic piece underneath the panels themselves that offer protection. I wish that was on both sides, especially with the bifold, which is glass. But here you can see I kind of left some MC4 connectors in place. This is actually the back part of the panel. You can see the glass backing, which is that bifold, and I left the protective cushioning in between because it is glass and you don't want to break it. There is a covering on it, a nice rubberized covering that helps to make this IP68 weather rated. And again, there are two sides to this. One side is your standard solar cell, as you would get with any other EcoFlow solar panel, and the other side is the glass, allowing you to get that bifold on the front side. You're supposed to be able to get up to 220 watts, and on the rear, depending on what's reflecting back at it, up to 155 watts. But let me show you what this looks like in its open state to give you a better idea of what we're looking at. Here we can see the panel in its open state. In this configuration, you're looking at 72 inches long with 32 inches high. So it is going to take up quite a bit of space. Now, one of the great things about EcoFlow is the solar efficiency of their panels, and the 220 watt bifold is no different in that it gives you 22 to 32% solar efficiency. So that means the sunlight that hits it and the conversion rate of turning that solar energy into usable power for your power bank has a 22 to 23% rating. Now, one of the big differences between this panel and other EcoFlow solar panels is if we walk it around, here we can see a nice close-up of the front solar cells coming around to the back. You can actually see, if I hold my hand over here, that it is see-through. There's glass on the back, which allows the solar panel to catch extra sunlight that's bouncing up in the back. Now, to fully utilize this, the best option for you is to open it up as you see. And if you used any other EcoFlow solar panels, you know that this configuration is a bit of a pain to actually set up because this is the Gen 1 version of the 220 watt panel, not the Gen 2 with the built-in kickstands. So you are going to have to contend with a larger, heavier, floppy wing solar panel to try and set it up. Now, because this is a bifold solar panel, I wanted to test how good it was in collecting energy from the standard sun, as well as the bounce from what's behind it. Let me show you what that testing was like.
It should be solar noon, so it should be getting 100% sunlight. And I'm gonna come over here.
It might be tricky to see, but we're getting about, saw peak at about 191.
Having it bounce off of the grass and just kind of propped up. Not perfect, because we're still looking at solar noon where the sun's directly above
it. All right, so I've gotten about a high of 170.
having it bounce off of the grass and just kind of propped up. Not perfect because we're still looking at solar noon where the sun's directly above us. So that's off the grass. We'll throw a white cloth behind it, see if that does anything. With attempting to kind of bounce some more light, but again, sun positioning is not optimal for this particular setup. So I'll go to about 170, 172 with attempting to kind of bounce some more light, but again, sun positioning is not optimal for this particular setup. Asphalt seems a little less reflective at 162. Tried to get the angle as best I could. Might be the blacktop is less reflective than grass.
Now, here are some numbers that I want to leave you with to compare what I was actually getting versus what is stated by EcoFlow. With standard grass, you're supposed to get 7.21% extra solar power. From sand, which is the closest thing I think up to that white backing, you're supposed to get 9.84%. Blacktop, well, I don't have concrete to test it on, but you're supposed to get 9.57. If you want the best solar reflecting extra boost, you want white snow, which will get you 14.89%, or a mirror at 24.85%. If you want to take full utilization of the back here, not only do you have to take your solar panels, you also have to take a mirror with you. Food for thought. Now, with EcoFlow solar panels, when I'm being lazy, I will just throw them out flat on the grass or on my deck to just get a quick solar charge. With this, you cannot do that because the glass back means you lose a lot of why you're actually paying all the money for this solar panel. But there's also a con that comes with this design in that when I was testing it and lying it flat for 10 minutes for a size comparison with my 160 watt, as well as just getting the charge from the sun with it flat in 10 minutes, I burned my grass in the shape of the solar panel very quickly. So you can't just lay it out flat. You wouldn't want to, but just know you can't do it even if you wanted to do it quick. The bifold nature of the solar panel also feels a little overhyped. As you saw from my testing numbers, I wasn't really getting that high of a percent extra by having something behind it, unless you're planning on bringing a mirror with you, which is just an extra thing. And this is already a very large and heavy solar panel and cumbersome with the wings. Again, this is the Gen 1. One other con that I came up with as I was putting this away, because of the actual glass nature of the solar panel, there's extra care that you need to have when transporting, moving, or putting it away, because you don't want to crack any of that. So you can't just fling it around like you would the other solar panel. That's not to say that it's not a good solar panel, and I really wanted to like it, but for the price to output that you get from this, honestly, I think EcoFlow has some better options in their 160 watt and even possibly now their 220 watt Gen 2, especially if you're looking at EcoFlow, which is my preferred solar panel manufacturer because they do make a good product. It's just this one to me is overpriced for the actual output that you get from it. However, if this review has not deterred you, I will have a link where you can pick one up for yourself in the description area below, but I will also have a link to the 160 watt panel, which is my preferred go-to EcoFlow panel at time of filming. I do have on order the 220 watt Gen 2, so I'll let you know how that is compared to this in a future review. If you appreciate the time and effort that goes into making a comprehensive video like this, make sure to hit that like button to help other people find the video as well. If you like what I'm doing here and want to be notified of my next review, make sure to hit that subscribe button. Still not sure if this is the right solar panel for you? On screen now, you'll see two other solar panel reviews that I have done to help you make a more informed decision for yourself.